Hello there. Again for today. This is my second video for the day, and I'm finally getting around to doing through the Bible, a second video on that, and it is 9:20 p.m. Pacific time on this Monday, April 24th, 2023. And so my previous video was Matthew 1. Now I'm going to read, maybe make some comments on Mark chapter 1 from the Gospel of Mark. There's Mark, there's Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Those are the four Gospels of the New Testament in the Bible. So this is chapter 1. In Mark, King James Version, public domain. Thank you, Lord, for this time. Bless our time together in your word, Lord, through the Bible. The beginning of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in the prophets in the Old Testament, behold, I send my messenger before thy face, which shall prepare thy way before thee. I believe this might be in Isaiah, but you can do your own research. As it is written in the prophets, behold, I send my messenger before thy face, which shall prepare thy way before thee. The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his path straight. John did baptize in the wilderness and preached the baptism of repentance for the remission of sins. And there went out unto him all the land of Judea, and they of Jerusalem, and were all baptized of him in the river of Jordan, confessing their sins. Now you can confess your sins right there where you are right now. You don't have to go to, you know, Jerusalem, the land of Judea. You don't have to go there. You can do it right there where you are from your heart, okay? And there went out unto him all the land of Judea, and they of Jerusalem, and were all baptized of him in the river of Jordan, confessing their sins. And go get baptized in water also, please. And John was clothed with camel's hair, and with the girdle of a skin about his loins, and he did eat locusts and wild honey, and preached, saying, there cometh one mightier than I, after me, the latchet of whose shoes I am not worthy to stoop down and unloose. And I indeed have baptized you with water, but he shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost. And it came to pass in those days that Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee, and was baptized of John in Jordan. And straightway coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens opened, and the Spirit, like a dove, descending upon him. Thank you, God. And there came a voice from heaven, saying, thou art my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. But God was speaking from heaven. Boy, that must have been amazing. God is speaking from heaven even right now, this day, this very second, this minute, and in your life every day. He's trying to speak to you and all of us, the whole world. And immediately the Spirit driveth him into the wilderness. And he was there in the wilderness 40 days, tempted of Satan, and was with the wild beasts, and the angels ministered unto him. Now after that, John was put in prison. That's a terrible story. Anyway, Jesus came into Galilee, preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God, and saying, the time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. He's saying this to us all right now. Repent ye and believe the gospel. Now some of us have already repented and stay in good standing with the Lord every day. But he's saying to the world and to our country, repent ye and believe the gospel. Believe, okay? Stop your unbelief. The major thing, the first major thing is to believe and to try to stop your unbelief, you know. And then after you're saved, you go through all these trials, and we still have to believe, and we need to always reject unbelief, because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word, and faith is what pleases God. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. And so faith comes by hearing, and hearing, and hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Now that's probably my paraphrase of the Amplified Bible. You check out the Amplified Bible always on Bible Gateway. There's so many versions of the Bible. Okay, so where was I before I interrupted myself? Okay, verse 16. Now, as he walked by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and Andrew, his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishers. Jesus was just walking by the Sea of Galilee, and he saw Simon and Andrew, his brother, and they were fishers. They were casting their net into the sea, for they were fishers. And Jesus said unto them, Come ye after me, and I will make you to become fishers of men. And straightway they forsook their nets and followed him. And when he had gone a little farther hence, he saw James the son of Zebedee and John his brother, who also were in the ship mending their nets. And straightway he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the ship with the hired servants and went after him. And they went into Capernaum, and straightway on the Sabbath day he entered into the synagogue and taught. And they were astonished at his doctrine, for he taught them as one that had authority and not as the scribes. I love this verse right here. And they were astonished at his doctrine, for he taught them as one that had authority and not as the scribes. And there was in their synagogue a man with an unclean spirit, and cried out, saying, Let us alone. What have we to do with thee, thou Jesus of Nazareth? Art thou come to destroy us? I know thee, who thou art, the Holy One of God. This was the demon speaking through this man. It was speaking through the man, okay? When Jesus Christ and the devil collide, sometimes there is a clash of the devil screeching out, screaming out, fighting, you know, fighting the Lord, acting out, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so he's acting out through this man. And you can see this today in this day and age. It's very plain to see all the time in the news, all the crime, this acting out crap from people that are allowing the devil to use them. Now, they don't know the devil's using them most of the time. But we as the church, we cast the devil out right now in the name of Jesus Christ, of these people, of everybody, out of ourselves. You know, out of everybody, okay? We as the church have this authority. We have this authority in Christ Jesus, okay? Okay, anyway, then, and Jesus rebuked him, saying, Hold thy peace and come out of him. He commanded the devil, come out. We command the devils to come out. The demons, come out in the name of Jesus. And when the unclean spirit had torn him and cried with a loud voice, he came out of him. He had to obey. Okay, we have authority over the devil. The devil and his demons have to obey us in Christ Jesus. Okay? And when the unclean spirit had torn him and cried with a loud voice, he came out of him. And they were all amazed, insomuch that they questioned among themselves, saying, What thing is this? What new doctrine is this? For with authority commandeth he even the unclean spirits, and they do obey him. And it's going to be a wonderful day when we see this happening in the church, not just in the church, but the church is doing its job all over this earth. And I'm not talking about going out and acting like a wild animal, like I do sometimes on Twitter or whatever. But you know what I'm saying? Okay, this should become just real. It's like drinking water or breathing air. This should have been happening a long time ago in the church or in from believers, okay? And if we start now, maybe we can get a hold of some of this hell out there going on, and people can be saved, they can be at peace, they can be safe. You know what I'm saying? Okay. And immediately his fame spread abroad throughout all the region round about Galilee. But see, we've made this into a naughty. This is a no-no. We don't talk about these things. We don't talk about the devil. I mean, God forbid we talk about the devil. Well, the devil's real, okay? And we need to stop not talking about the devil because he's real. Now, we don't put him on a pedestal. And we don't, you know, there's not a devil under every rock, but there could be. And if there is, cast him out. Cast him out of the rocks. The rocks will cry out and praise the Lord. Okay, you know what I'm talking about. Read between the lines. And immediately his fame spread abroad throughout all the region round about Galilee. And forthwith, when they were come out of the synagogue, they entered into the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. So they were in the synagogue. But Simon's wife's mother lay sick of a fever, and anon they tell him of her. And he came and took her by the hand and lifted her up, and immediately the fever left her, and she ministered unto them. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to get through all of this. I think I should not try. Let's see. Let's just read quickly through it, okay? And at even when the sun did set, they brought unto him all that were diseased and them that were possessed with devils. And all the city was gathered together at the door. And he healed many that were sick of divers diseases and cast out many devils and suffered not the devils to speak because they knew him. And in the morning, rising up a great while before day, he went out and departed into a solitary place and there prayed. And Simon and they that were with him followed after him. And when they had found him, they said unto him, All men seek for thee. And he said unto them, Let us go into the next towns, that I may preach there also, for therefore came I forth. And he preached in their synagogues throughout all Galilee and cast out devils. And there came a leper to him, beseeching him, and kneeling down to him, and saying unto him, If thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. Oh, people are crying out for help, people. People are crying out for help, church. Okay, and Jesus, moved with compassion, put forth his hand and touched him, and saith unto him, I will, be thou clean. And as soon as he spoke, immediately the leprosy departed from him, and he was cleansed. I think that might be, do your own research, an incurable disease of leprosy. Okay, so with God all things are possible. And he straitly charged him, and forthwith sent him away, and saith unto him, See thou say nothing to any man, but go thy way, show thyself to the priest, and offer for thy cleansing those things which Moses commanded for a testimony unto them. But he went out and began to publish it much, and to blaze. Maybe that's where the blaze got the name of their, you know, their name of their thing, the blaze abroad, to blaze abroad the matter, insomuch that Jesus could no more openly enter into the city, but was without in desert places, and they came to him from every quarter. Lord, we just thank you for your word. Thank you for Mark chapter 1, Lord, and Matthew chapter 1, previous through the Bible, New Testament, Gospels. Lord, we thank you for your word. Give everybody a peace-filled life, evening, week ahead. Protect, heal, bless, prosper, every need met. Salvation for every soul. Touch the children, salvation for all the children and healing and protection. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Thank you for watching. God bless.